As of right now, the buffed wood look is winning out at a ratio of about 3-1 over the CA. Now, just because you like CA better doesn't mean you're wrong. There's no right or wrong answer here. It's whatever you prefer. That's what's right for you. Now, I actually have two of these Canadiana kits. You may have seen me get the other one in that box opening video about 4 or 5 days ago. And the other one is a fountain pen version of this same kit. So I'll be using the CA finished blanks on that one, and that will become my own personal pen. Now, I know that I'm a ballpoint pen person. However, I'm finding that the fountain pen, well, it's kind of a novelty. I'm just trying to see, can I learn to write with it all over again? Now, I've already concluded that right here will match up better with right here than anywhere else. So that means that the nib holder is going to have to go in this end here. Oh my, that went on way too easy. Pressed it on with my fingers here. Okay, here's a case where we're going to use a little tiny bit of CA thin. I've had to do this before, but not very often. Now I realized that I said I was going to use thin, but I've changed my mind. I'm going to use medium here, because it'll give me a lot more working time. Now, that plastic probably won't start the CA curing very quick, but this piece of wood might. Now, the trick is, don't use very much. That should be plenty. Now we'll press it on. Now I was not anticipating having to use the press here. I thought I'd be able to push it on with my fingers like before, but I guess I didn't have it lined up quite right. Anyway, I should have had the press ready. Oh, that was a close call. I could have dropped this into that CA, but I didn't. And being as I show my mistakes, well, there we go. Now, when I'm shooting these videos, what I'll do is I'll take a shot or two, then I'll run upstairs and I'll edit it out on my computer and, sort of breaks it up. In other words, I don't shoot the whole thing and then edit it out at the end of the day. So I sometimes see things in the editing that I missed. Turns out that this did drop in the CA on the toothpick. So now I've got to see if I can get this little tiny, that you can almost, like you can't see it with the naked eye almost. But I want to get it off of there. I want this to be perfect. I'm going to be giving this pen away. Anyway, let's see what we can do. It's here somewhere.
the light just right. Why can't I see it now? Oh yeah, there it is, right there. Now this does not have to be real tight, it just has to hold it here so we can see it. My thinking is, it's sitting on a waxed surface. I don't think it's soaked in. This is a piece of very soft cedar, and I'm thinking possibly I can sort of scrape it off and rebuff. Let's see what happens here. Okay, it's so minute, I mean, I could probably leave it. You can't see it with the naked eye, but I'm picky. Okay, I got it. I picked it off with my fingernail. Sorry, I didn't have the camera running, but it was right there. That was lucky. Now, quite a bit of time has passed, probably about an hour since our disaster. I just want you to notice here that CA medium, it hasn't set on the plastic. It did on the toothpick, though. Well, it's interesting to me anyway. Now, I'm following these assembly steps in the order that they are in the instructions. Some of these steps could be done a little bit differently. Now, you see this spring? It's a little bit cone-shaped. The wide end has to go in first, and I think the idea is that it's supposed to sort of wedge itself into the bottom there. Let's see if this actually works, so that it won't fall out. Yeah, so that you don't accidentally lose it when you go to change your refill later. Okay. I think that's supposed to go like that. Okay, then this should go in here. And look, for once I didn't get ink on my fingers. And this should screw in. Okay, this part is done. Now, the next step is I'm going to be pressing all of this together into one end here. However, this will be screwing in like this. When I have this thing screwed in and it comes to a stop, like right there, okay, that's as far as it goes, I want the grain on here to be lined up in the right place. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a felt marker. Take a little felt marker, and I will mark it right here. Then I will know that this part here will be pressed on. Let's get it just right. Okay, I think you know what I'm trying to say here. And that way, when you screw the cap on, it will stop in the right spot, and the grain will line up. Yeah, I think I should be able to see that. Now you're probably noticing that the parts are getting less and less here. Okay. Gonna go on here. This should go on here. And then this should go here. Now, remember, I want to get that mark, the felt marker mark, right in the middle between that those two black lines. I think I pretty much got it. Okay. Now just double check now. Maybe you could go just a little bit more this way. All right, this all should press up nice and flush here. Well, looks pretty good to me. I've got a little block of mahogany here, and I'm pretty sure that I made this up 2 years ago just for this purpose. Okay. Now the idea is, I don't want to be pushing this in too far, because if I did, I wouldn't be able to screw this on later. And actually later is right now. Okay, this should go like this. And normally I'd be quite concerned about where I was going to get the clip on, but being as it's a screw-on type pull down here instead of a press-on, I'll be able to worry about it afterwards. And once again, afterwards is right now. Oh, what do I not want to hide here? I don't want to hide this. I don't want to hide that. Decisions, decisions. Sort of like, which is best? The CA finish or the buffed finish? I just can't make up my mind here. Oh, let's just crank it down and we'll change it later if I want to. All right, let's get this all cleaned up, have a nice little look, and then we'll do the test.
Well, this took a little bit longer than I had thought it was going to today. And, well, we did have that one little problem with the CA glue on the finish, but anyway, another one successfully completed. Thanks for watching. You too, Jackson.